Okay, this is, oh, let me clear this out. I don't need that label. Alright, this is three lines, X, X, X. They're on top of each other. You can't see them. And then you've got F of 1 times F of 2, which is the parabola. And then you've got F of, which that's F of 4, as you can see there. And then F5, which is this. No, this one. Because it's a little steeper, because it's cubed. It's F of 5, which is F of 4 times F of 3. So, and I'm going to move these things around. These are the parents of these fancy ones. All right, so if I flatten right now, all three are positive, all three are 1, so those are, that's just your basic X cubed and X squared parabolas. Now if I flatten this guy out, F of 3 out, it's going to affect the cubic function but not the parabola, because it's not bound by it. And now let me just, because it was on top, let me just show you this. Right, see, these, this is X times X times 3/400 X, and as I flatten them, all, any of these or all of them, it affects all. Now see, this one's starting to affect the parabola. Now all this is on the input side, and there's nothing I can do. I can change this, watch, with just for behavior standpoint, the end behavior of this quad, of this cubic, is negative, and I've got two positive lines. If I pull one more of them negative, now the parents are two negative, one positive, and the end behaviors go with the single. In other words, it's like the doubles undo themselves. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but now, no matter what I do, I can't change where these guys are solved, because there's this input is bound by just the coefficients of X. Now, if I put a linear term in it, now I'm not putting a constant, I'm not putting the C, I'm just putting in the B, because it's on the input side. I can shift stuff around, and then this is going to get messy, because I can't, how it's bound is on two different lines, and I don't know how to undo it. But all right, now I'm going to grab this, I'm going to shift, this is F of 2, yeah, this is the parabola. I tell you what, let me get this one that's on the cubic. I'm going to get it kind of out of, to be less to look at. All right, see, now watch that, see how that affects it, but it's still got that solution there and this solution. Now that's the linear term that's causing that, not the constant, because I can't. All right, see, this is the parabola on top. If one's negative, it's a negative times a positive, so it goes negative. But if I negate this one, not negate it, but if I put it down, it makes the parabola go positive, because a negative times a negative is a positive. So, Lord, now I lost another line. Where's it? Oh, that's it right there. Now, see, another thing kind of to notice is, let me get him back up here in the action. I've got, there's no way I can change solutions. I can shift. Here, I'm about to just pull off one of these. Well, let me put this guy back down. I'm going to change the linear term here. See that? This line crosses here. This one crosses here. So this parabola has always got to cross there, because that's where the parents crossed. And same thing if I move. Oh man, I got a multi-select. Okay, what about this one? You see how that does that? And even if I move this solution over negative, let me go up real steep. Now it's negative, but still doesn't matter. I'm on the input side of this function, meaning I can't. It's going to take a C value to push or pull this guy up. And remember, under the quadratic formula, it's minus 4ac, the b squared minus 4ac. That C term is what is on the output side that can force you to have imaginary solutions, because you can't compute an imaginary solution. If I put, but the C term can, because it's on the outside, it's after the function has been run or something, the cubic, the main body of it is run, you can tack on something. So I'm going to go down here, let me get everything back. Okay, well, that's the parabola, right? Let me get this back. Right, this is our parabola right here. See that blue or whatever, pink or something, I can't tell. That's it. I'm going to get it a little bit closer. All right, now look at there. It's close. Now it's bound by these two dudes here. So I'm going to take f of 1. Let's see, f of 1 right here. And I'm going to... No, I can't do it there because it's still on the input side. I got to do it at 3. I got to do it here because... No, I got to do it at 4 because this is f of 1 plus f of 2. So I've got to put here something that can force that imaginary solution, that square root of a negative. So I'm gonna push this guy up. That I guess that's 1. That's 1 negative. So I'm gonna push it up 2. Plus 2 on the output side. Boom! Now it's imaginary. There would have been no way I could have done that if I did it on the input side. So if I get rid of it. And now let me go to one of the input functions right here. This is one right here. I'm going to put plus 2 there. See, it didn't... It moved it, but it was on the input side. So it affected more it affected the output, but not from a calculation standpoint. In other words, the only way you're going to get... If you see a parabola that's not touching, you might can find the parents by factoring or whatever, but you're not going to find all of them. You're going to... Well, I'm not even saying that right. It came as output. You had to add or subtract. If I make this one of these negative, watch this. If I go... Wait, that's graphed. Because this is the one that's not. Now that it's negative, see this. Wait, am I confusing myself? Yeah, that's not the right one. It's supposed to be this one right here. I'm trying to show you that if you... No, that's not moving. That's the graph. Let me pause it and see what I'm not doing right. Okay, I can't unfix that, but I can do this. I can take f of 4 right here. This is the parabola right there. And the only way I can make it... See, there's nothing I can do to get it, to free it up from being bound by those solutions. As long as it's... See, when it goes positive, it flips over to curving this way. But if I spin it around negative... It drops down. No, it goes above it because it opens downward. Now, this c value is going to have to be a subtraction. So I can go to f of 4 right here, and I'm going to go minus 2. And see, that forced it out because that changes what's under the radical. Well, from a quadratic formula standpoint, it does. But at any rate. I'll be redoing this because I don't think I did that well at it.